three poems. The first one is for Charlotte, who's out there somewhere in the dark. It's called Empty Bed. I stare at the black above me, too awake to sleep, too tired to think. My body twists vacantly to fill the emptiness of the bed. I can't close my eyes. I want to know where you are, what you are doing, who you will be tomorrow. I feel like a ghost and worry you will never see me again or disappear yourself. I hate tonight. I move to the couch, bringing your pillow with me. I can see the sky through the open curtains. I stare at the stars. There are so many, so far away. I turn towards the back of the couch, trying to make the night smaller. The cat meows for you again and again. I need you here. I need to feel you wrapped around me, your naked breast against my back, the soft sound of your breath in my ear. I need to know we are together in the emptiness. I need to know I'm not a ghost. This next piece I would like to dedicate to single mothers, in particular my own, who probably had the worst job ever to raise a son. It's called Meat Packer and Son. Mother sits heavy, formica yellow kitchen, meat chunks on plastic boots, blood splotched packing plant whites, swollen hands rubbing freezer ache bones, blank after work eyes. Son fidgets on mother's lap, his head buried in her hair, tired breath and ferreting eyes, torso held, legs splayed limp, strawberry milk-stained shirt, Spider-Man iron-on patch pants, playground feet. Bedtime dinner, tuna potato chip casserole, pop-top diet Pepsi, apartment brown butter shag, former tenant toothpaste holes, Kit Kat clock, eyes, tail swinging, church camp God's eye, tied to ceiling hook, dangling. Corporate coffee. The hemp-wearing probe tester fights against the man. He's preaching to the masses. He's telling us the plan. He's against the corporations, and on that I must agree. But when he starts attacking Starbucks, I say, listen to me, please. It's the insurance man, the tax man, and those wacky cops. These are the corporations we really need to stop, because you can skip your Starbucks mocha and still get on quite well. But if you miss your payments, you'll soon find you're in jail. They've got you hustling for the dollar, working day by day to pay your corporate masters while you slave your life away. So take on your McDonald's, your Gap, and your Nike, but if you don't go fight the big ones, you never will be free.